Hey guys, this is Amanda of Vixen Studio, and today I'm going to do my first ever casting call tutorial featuring Crimson Rose's lovely What on Earth. From now on, I think I'm going to do these casting calls for all my tutorials on different topics. So keep an eye out for these on the forums. So today I'm going to do a full color change. And I'm starting unusually with a blank canvas, completely blank. And so I'm gonna kind of walk you through again my process of finding horses, finding backgrounds that suit them and whatever. So the first thing I'm gonna do is do something a little unusual today. Where'd it go? Here we go. I'm going to go to Flickr to find thoroughbred stock, since this is a thoroughbred. And yeah, there's not a lot of Palomino thoroughbreds, but that's the whole point of today's tutorial, is to show you how to change the color. Flickr actually is a great place to find stocks, and I'm gonna show you real quick how to find stocks suitable for horse Eden on Flickr. So the first thing we're gonna do is I'm gonna search thoroughbred. There are some really great stock providers on here who exist solely to provide stock for sims, both like forum sims and games like Horse Eden and Equiverse and whatever. So the way to do this and to filter through all these professional photos is to go over here, and you will need a Flickr account or a Yahoo account in order to do this. So you should set one of those up if you plan on using Flickr. So what you're gonna do once you've done that is search whatever you're looking for, any license, and you're gonna go down to modifications allowed. You can't use just all Creative Commons because there's a lot more specifics applied to those licenses, so you're gonna wanna find modifications allowed. And you're gonna click that, and then it's gonna sort through all of these. And most of these will be okay to use. If you find one that you like for instance, there's one stock provider that I absolutely love. Their name is Shaz Stock Flickr, and this is a confirmed okay to use account. It's a great account, really high quality images, but they're all very thoroughbred-y, so you gotta be careful. All of her images are safe to use on Horse Eden. It's been cleared by the mods, so feel free to use these images. And I'm actually going to use an image from here today for our tutorial horse. So I've already kind of scoped them out. What I'm going to do, since the horse is a Palomino that we're working with, I'm going to choose a chestnut horse to work with. And the reason is because on Palomino horses, a Palomino is just a dilute of the chestnut coat. So you're going to want to start with that, and the reason is because they don't have any black points, so when you're changing the horse's color, you're not going to have to deal with recoloring the points and yada yada yada. So this is a nice horse. And I'm going to go horse first today. I kind of like that photo because it has a lot of action going on. I'm going to scroll through just for good measure. There's a lot of really high quality images on here. She's a really great find. You know what, I think I'm just going to use that image, because I really do like it. Where'd it go? They all look kind of, they're very thoroughbred-y though, so some people might not like them. Where'd it go? There it is. Okay. So we're going to download it. Original size. So this is the image I'm going to work from. Now to DeviantArt to find a background for it. this, because I haven't used something like this before, and it's pretty colorful. I like the colors. Okay, so we're gonna use this. Okay. So, I'm gonna create a composition. That'll work. Okay. Pretty typical stuff so far. Okay, so the horse is more or less cut out now. So the first thing I'm gonna do before I start recoloring it is I'm going to remove the halter and the auction hip sticker thing they put on the racehorses. Pretty easy fixes, real quick. My last tutorial, or no, my first tutorial we did, I showed you how to remove stuff like this with the clone tool. So this will be a little refresher on that for you. Pretty easy fix. Shouldn't take more than a couple seconds. Halter, it's a little bit more complicated, especially with this dramatic lighting. That shadow is going to be a pain. Alright. Well, we'll make it work. Whoops, too close. Again, don't forget the trick of taking a similar shade from nearby and applying it onto the face to avoid that really repetitive patterning effect you can get. You just keep using the same material from the face. That's done, more or less. We can start on the recoloring. So the first thing I'm gonna do, excuse me, is I'm just gonna do my basic horse prep with this horse. So I'm gonna smudge over him. Low strength tool, preferably a soft brush like this. Oops, I forgot the top of his halter. This is going to help smooth out any imperfections. It's also going to give the horse that smooth look, and it's also going to help that kind of help blend in his face a bit. Next thing I'm gonna do is blur out the background. This one's gonna be a little bit tricky because there's a lot of stuff in the middle ground. This is the middle ground right here. This is the background, so the trees are gonna be kind of a problem, and there's a lot of stuff going on, just a lot of stuff going on in general in this background, so it's not really a background, it's a background, a middle ground, and a foreground all in one, so I'll try to handle it decently. These can get kind of tricky. Oops. So what I'm doing is I'm going back through and unselecting this tree because I want it to be somewhat defined. I don't want it to be totally blurred out because it's in the middle ground. Which means I gotta go through and trace all of these brush or all these branches, more or less, so they stay somewhat in focus. Same thing down here with these little bits of the bush in the front. It's good enough, I think. Oops. Yeah. So we're gonna want all of that. This is gonna be kind of tricky. So I might get a little bit quiet as I'm concentrating. Okay. I think that's okay for now. Feather. Filter. Blur, lens blur. So it's kind of showing us here what it'll look like. I'm gonna bump it down to like 6. Okay. I might do it one more time. Just go through with the blur tool and soften that tree up. Yeah, that. You can also do that to the flowers a bit, just to push them back out of focus. But not quite to the degree as the background. Makes it a little bit more believable, the depth of field. Care about the background. Alright, something else tricky about this is going to be the overlapping of the twigs in the bottom. I really picked like the worst possible background for this, but this is good, because this will kind of give you an idea of how to handle these kinds of materials in your backgrounds. Okay. You know, I think he's a tad big. Make him a little bit smaller. Okay, that's better. Alright, so like we said before, when you blur out the background, it kind of reveals all these little scraps that you miss, so I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of those, because they're gonna really pop once we start recoloring, and I'll show you why in a second. So once again, I'm going to fast forward through this. Mm-hmm. Okay, so there are a couple of different ways to approach this. Sorry, I keep yawning. No coffee. Some people prefer, when they're recoloring a horse, to totally grayscale it, which means turning off all the color and getting rid of all of it and just replacing it yourself, using different methods. But another way to do it is the way I'm going to show you. This is how I prefer to do it, because I think grayscaling is an art of its own, and it's kind of tedious, and it's kind of it can be kind of overwhelming. I don't do it a lot. It's not my preferred method, so I'm just going to show you kind of what I do. And that's why it's important to choose the right type of horse, the right base color before you start this. So I don't do this a whole lot, so might be a little bit unrefined, this process, but you'll get the idea. Okay. So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to go through and I'm going to select the areas of the horse that I want to preserve. So I'm going to select like the muzzle down here. I don't want that to get washed out. The eye, I don't want to get washed out. Any kind of, like the hooves, I'm going to go and select them. Any area on the horse that would still be the same color regardless. So like down here, this area pretty much more or less be the same. This white, you're not going to want it any whiter. The hooves, you're going to want to be the same color, so on and so forth. It's really just the coat, that chestnut color that we want changed, and the mane. But luckily we've selected a flaxen horse, so we won't have to worry about it too much. It doesn't have to be perfect, just kind of more or less. I'm going to add a refined edge to it too. Feather the edge a bit, so it's not quite so obvious. Alright. So now, I'm going to select the inverse. So go to select and then inverse, and that's going to select everything that you didn't already select. So it's going to select this part of the horse instead of what you traced. So we're going to go up to adjustments, brightness, contrast. I'm going to brighten it just a bit. More or less keep the contrast the same. Actually, you know what? Psych, because the horse's eye is not selected anymore. So I'm going to hit this part, this option, because I'm going to subtract from what's selected instead of adding to what's selected. Okay. Now we can do this. So open up the brightness a bit, not too much. Gonna actually do a bit of grayscaling. I'm gonna turn the saturation down because we're gonna replace the saturation. So obviously we're going to up the yellow because it's a palomino. I decided not to do the grayscaling thing because it was going to wash out the color too much. Okay. So I'm going to play. I love color balance. You're going to use color balance so much. It's such a great tool. There we go. See. Okay. Cool. So that's good. And now, to make his mane white. Select it, make that in his tail. Oops, we're still in the inverse, okay. So that was pretty easy for a palomino. Buckskin would be kind of the same thing. You'd start with a bay horse, play around with it in color balance. So now, to brighten the mane up, handy dandy brightness contrast. I'm gonna turn the contrast down a bit. And now you get to go into... Oops, wrong one. Hue and saturation. No, that's what I just did. Vibrance. That's what I wanted. And turn the saturation down. But keep the vibrance turned up. See? Awesome. And ba-boom! We now have a palomino horse. Pretty cool. This is the horse we started with. Pretty cool, huh? Cool. Alright, guys, that's pretty much how you do color changes. This one wasn't particularly difficult, but that's my technique. Find a horse, a base color of that dilute. So a chestnut, you would, for a palomino, you choose a chestnut. For a buckskin, you would choose a bay. If you're doing a smoky black or, whatever, you would choose a black horse. Usually also when I'm doing roans, like blue roans, I start with a black horse and then kind of blue them up. Or if I'm doing a red roan, I choose a chestnut and then, you know, so forth. Or a strawberry roan, I use a chestnut. So that's pretty much it. I'm going to fix this guy up and get him to his new owner. So thanks a lot for watching, guys. See you next time. Oh, and keep a lookout for my next casting call tutorial. So thanks for watching.